as each round came in, the concussion and the shockwave would just kind of rock the buildings, and it would push doors in and push them back out.
This is one of the areas damaged in the blasts. It was a military barracks, and many soldiers here had only a few minutes to evacuate to nearby bunkers before the missiles hit.
Me and my partner, we hit the floor and we felt the big boom, and it's just, it got real quick. You're just like, damn, I hope the next one doesn't fall on me. It's just, everything just crosses your mind.
You're a soldier, you're trained, but were you scared?
I was. I'm also human. I was scared, yeah.
So we did get some advance warning by a couple of hours. We weren't sure what the threat was at the beginning.
If you compare the previous rocket attacks with this one.
Yeah, it seems funny. It seems like somebody was throwing pebbles at us after the missile. So the next day I was saying that, you know, if we faced any threats, it would probably be just rockets. And it was the first time in my career that I caught myself, you know, categorizing a rocket as just a rocket.
It's clear, had the U.S. not received advance warning, there would have been casualties.
They targeted living quarters. They targeted known structures that were occupied. And so I don't think that they had any hesitation to inflict those casualties.
Where we're at is where my room used to be. It was an X camp. It's pretty much where I used to sleep, talk to my family whenever I wasn't working, where I would unwind.
The other thing I will tell you is the way that the attacks were organized, the way the volleys were set up, they were spaced out. And I think it enticed us to come out because there was a pause after that initial volley. I think that they allowed for time to pass after the initial attack for us to come out, make on-the-spot assessments, start looking for potential casualties, and then the next wave of missiles started coming in. So I think that was very deliberate. We understand that the threat is still out there. I would say that we're at a strategic operational pause, but that could change any moment. If the threat goes down, we're ready to get back to work in defeating ISIS, and everybody remains committed to that.
I came here with the mentality that we're coming here because of ISIS, and then a couple months in, I'm like, okay, now there's somebody else. Yeah.